Hey, I'm Paul Duty with Climb Aviation. Today I wanted to talk to you about various flight control systems that you can use with your home flight simulator. I'm going to talk about five different types of controls, including the mouse, a joystick, and three different control yokes. So let's dive right into this. So the most basic type of flight control is going to be the mouse. If you don't have another control system, you can use the mouse. Pull back to go up, push forward to go down, left is left and right is right. It's basic, it functions, it works, but it's not very realistic. So you don't really get the feel for how an airplane is supposed to fly when your hands are in the mouse. So for those reasons alone, unless you don't have another control system, I don't recommend flying with the mouse. All right, so next let's talk about the Logitech Extreme 3D Pro joystick. So if you're flying an aircraft that has a side stick or a center stick, maybe that's an Airbus or a Cirrus or one of the sport or experimental aircraft out there, then this might actually be your stick of preference. So if you're flying an airplane that has a yoke, then I highly recommend that you use the yoke control to get a far more realistic feel. But if your plane has a stick, then use a joystick. There's lots of joysticks available with lots of different options. The Extreme 3D Pro is pretty basic, but it has everything that you're gonna need. It has your pitch control, it has your roll control. It also has a twist function for the rudders. I actually don't use that because that's not how rudders are controlled. They're usually controlled with your feet. So I usually just disable that, in which case the flight simulator is going to auto-coordinate the rudder control for you. But there's lots of buttons that are programmable for any kind of function that you want in your simulator. You've got a hat switch, a trigger switch, another button over here on the left, and you have this throttle control, which is convenient to have that right there at your fingertips. So that's the Logitech Extreme 3D Pro joystick. Next up, let's talk about the CH Products Flight Sim Yoke. So the CH Products Flight Sim Yoke has been available for quite some time. It's a pretty basic yoke. It's an entry level yoke. It has all the basic functions that you'll need on a flight control yoke, and it's available if you're on a budget. The nice thing about this yoke is it does have the throttle, the prop, and the mixture control installed on it. So those are available. So you have all three of those controls. They are on top, which can get in the way sometimes. Most pilots like to fly with their left hand on the yoke and the right hand on the controls. And you kind of can see I have to reach around the yoke to operate the throttle, the prop, and the mixture. So that can get a little in the way. Plus, if you like to mount your yoke underneath your desk, then that's not gonna work. With these throttle, prop, and mixture controls on top, it just gets in the way. So you do have plenty of buttons though on this control yoke. So you have two buttons here on the body of the yoke. You have trim buttons, a couple of buttons on top, a hat switch, and then there's two more buttons on the back side of the handles. That you can program. You have a trim wheel, and the trim wheel is a little bit different. Instead of just sliding or turning around, this trim wheel only moves in either direction for up or down pitch, and really all that does is just tells the simulator where the center point is of your yoke. So on this yoke, this one is a little bit sticky, so it doesn't really have much of a center detent to it, but it does stick. It doesn't always return directly back to its center point. So if you're trying to fly hands off, you might have to force it to go back to the center point. The yoke itself turns about 45 degrees to the left or to the right, and it has about 2.5–3 inches of travel on the pitch axis. So it works. It's not very solid, but it is available if you're on a budget. Oh, the mounting system on this is also a little funky. The mounting system requires you to have a desk that's at least about 3/4 to 1 inch thick. The feet that are on this have these screw clamps that will only go down to that depth. So if your desk is thinner than that, or if you're using a virtual cockpit or a racing rig or something with a flat metal top to it, then you're gonna have to use some type of a spacer, and in which case it really doesn't hold it very securely onto the desk. So that's the CH Products Flight Sim Yoke. Next, let's talk about the Logitech Flight Yoke System. All right, this is the Logitech Pro Flight Yoke System. The Logitech system used to be made by Cytec, and a few years ago, Logitech took over the manufacturing of those peripherals. And the only thing that's really changed on the body of this is they added a little G on the front to it to represent the Logitech gaming line of controls. So it's a nice system. It's mostly plastic, except for it does have a metal shaft on it. It has a very substantial mount to it. And this is actually the mount here. And the way that this works is it goes into the front of the yoke, and then there's a screw clamp on the bottom. And this screw clamp can attach to a desk of any thickness. So even if you have just a flat metal tabletop, this will go down to it. And then it has kind of a rubber pad here that holds it firmly in place. On the yoke itself, you have about 2.5 to 3 inches of travel on the pitch axis, and it turns about 45 degrees to the left and to the right. You have plenty of buttons on the yoke. You have a hat switch, trim switch, another trim switch. You can use this for flaps. There are buttons on the back. There's a push to talk, another accessory button here, 3-position switch on the right hand side. Plus you have a digital display for a timer or a clock. If you're doing any instrument training or you want to practice instrument approaches, then you know how important that is to be able to have a clock that's easily accessible to start and stop the time. So you have that built in here. The other nice thing about this is you have several holes on top, and these are to mount various accessories. So Logitech has a switch panel, a radio panel, a autopilot panel, flight information panels. Those can mount directly to the top of this, or you can mount them to the sides, depending on your preference. There's a few other third-party companies, some real sim gear accessories that can mount directly to the top of this yoke. On the bottom of it, if you didn't want to use this mount, there are 4 threaded holes that can be used to mount directly to a tabletop surface. So like the Glime Virtual Cockpit, those are pre-drilled to accept this yoke without having to make any additional modifications. So that is the Logitech Flight Yoke System. The yoke also comes with a throttle. So this throttle is very nice. It has a throttle, prop, and mixture control. It has 3 buttons, and these buttons have a 1 and a 2 position on them, so just rocker switches there. This throttle actually plugs directly into the yoke itself. So it looks like it has a PS2 connector. Do not plug this in directly into your computer. If you do, your computer probably won't turn on, in which case you'll contact us or contact support, and they'll say, well, make sure you plug it directly into the back of the yoke. There's also a USB hub there. It's not powered, but there is a USB hub with several different USB ports. So you can plug in something that has very minimal power consumption, like a rudder pedal there. Or if you were to purchase an additional throttle quadrant, say if you had a multi-engine airplane, the additional throttle quadrants actually use a USB connection. And you can use those and plug those directly into the yoke, or you can plug those into your computer if you need additional power. So you can stack those throttle quadrants, and then you can reassign what each lever functions as. So if you're in a multi-engine airplane, you can pop these knobs off and you can put them where they need to go. So if you needed to have 2 throttles, 2 propellers, 2 mixture controls, you can easily just pop them off and reassign them within your system. So it's nice to have that flexibility, and this yoke does come with one of those throttles. All right, so now let's talk about the new kid on the block. That is the Honeycomb Aeronautical Switch Panel and Yoke. This is known as the Alpha Switch Panel and Yoke, and this became available in the fall of 2019. And this is a very, very nice yoke. So this yoke, very solid. You can tell that they paid a lot of attention to how this was constructed, how it's built. It's covered in a very smooth texture, so it's really hard to tell even what this is even made out of. But it kind of has a soft rubberized texture to it. And that's on the body of the yoke, plus it's what the yoke itself is wrapped in the handles. So the ergonomics of this control system are amazing. So this feels just like the real airplane. It has lots of buttons on it. You've got your hat switch to look around. Even the trim switches are built with these little detents that you can fit your thumbs right into, which makes it easy to feel the controls and feel which button you're on without actually looking at them, so you can maintain visual on your screen. So the buttons here, it's nice that it has this built-in switch panel. You've got your alternator, your battery, your avionics bus 1 and 2. You've got 5 different light switches, and you have a 5-position magneto switch. It goes from off, right mag, left mag, both, or start. I think the one downside on that switch is it's not spring loaded. So it doesn't spring from start back to both the way that it would in a real airplane. So I've seen some folks where they leave the starter on the start position, and then you might get an annunciator on your panel that says that you have low voltage, or you might hear some type of like a clicking sound. What that is that the starter is still engaged. Once the airplane starts, you have to turn that switch back to both to be on the magnetos, and then the starter will be off. So this has a solid shaft to it, and because of that, the wires for the buttons don't run through the shaft to the yoke. So they give you this coil cable, which is kind of like a Cat 5 cable, just plugs in and uses that for the connections on the buttons. So this connects with a USB, actually all of these connect with a USB cable, but this one uses a USB-C cable, which is replaceable in the back. So speaking of in the back of this, there's a button that you can turn on some lights. It has a kind of a dim red backlit to it, but the nice thing is you can actually brighten that up. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different brightness settings on that backlit. Personally, I don't really use that much. If I'm flying at night and my panel is lit up, then I might turn that on. But most of the time when I'm flying, I just leave it off because my panel in the plane is not gonna be backlit anyway. But this yoke is very nice. The travel on the pitch, like the others, it's about 2.5 to 3 inches. However, one of the biggest differences, and this is really, really important, is this actually has a full 90 degrees of travel on the roll axis. And why that's important is because a lot of people have told me when they're flying a flight simulator home, either with the CH or the Logitech system, that they just feel too sensitive. Well, the reality of it is the plane is flying just fine. It's the control yoke. When your control yoke only turns 45 degrees to the left or to the right, your simulator actually interprets that as a full deflection, which is 90 degrees of deflection to the left or to the right. So you're actually getting twice the amount of control out of that motion on the Logitech or CH yoke. With the Honeycomb, it's 1 for 1. If you turn it halfway, the simulator only turns halfway. So that 90 degrees of deflection is going to give you a far more accurate feel when you're flying the airplane. So that's the Honeycomb system. It's an amazing system. The mount on it is, let me show you that. So here's the mount. So it starts with this base plate, and this base plate has this kind of sticky back to it. And when you peel this off, this just attaches to your tabletop. As long as it's a pretty smooth surface, it will work on most. What I have found is that on some powder coated tabletops, or if it is a wood grain that has a lot of texture to it, then it might not really hold very well. So in that case, they have these clamps. So the way these clamps work is they attach to the base plate like that, and then they screw down to clamp onto your tabletop surface. So that's similar to the Logitech system. However, this only goes down to roughly about 1/2 inch thick. So if your table is less than 1/2 inch thick, then like the CH, you're gonna have to use some type of a metal spacer to hold that securely in place. That's how I do it on the Glime Virtual Cockpit and other racing rigs. So this is by far the most solidly built system, and the mount is very solid. It's not going to go anywhere. It's not going to move around. It's not going to shift on you. So that's the Honeycomb yoke. All right, so let's review. So we have the mouse, which is the most basic way to control your home flight simulator. You have a joystick, which is nice if you have a center stick or a side stick, and then you have 3 different yokes to choose from. So the Logitech joystick, this starts at around $40. And then there are a lot of joysticks available on the market. Try to find something that accurately represents what you're gonna fly in the airplane. This Logitech joystick it's pretty universal, so you can use it for a lot of different types of aircraft without incurring any kind of negative training. So the CH yoke usually runs about $130 to $140 depending on your favorite retailer. Remember, it only has that 45 degrees of motion. The mount on it is not very solid, and depending on how you need to mount it to your desk, the throttle, prop, and mixture controls may get in the way of that. The Logitech yoke system, it's pretty solidly built, it's very reliable. It is a hollow plastic yoke and doesn't necessarily have the best ergonomics, and it only also turns 45 degrees. This system usually runs about $169.95 at just about any retailer that you can find it at. The Honeycomb Alpha switch panel and yoke, by far the most advanced of the three. This is probably the best yoke that I've ever used in any flight simulator. And I mean that even in some of the simulators I've flown that are hundreds of thousands of dollars, this one has the perfect feel to it. Great ergonomics, it's solid, it feels good, it's got plenty of buttons, plenty of switches on it, and it works very, very well. So no matter what system you use, anything is better than just using the mouse. The mouse is not very realistic, so of course I don't recommend that. The Honeycomb is by far probably the clear winner, even though it does not have a throttle, but you can purchase a throttle separately from Logitech, or eventually Honeycomb is going to be coming out with their own throttle system as well. So we hope you enjoyed this video. We hope you learned something. If you have any questions, feel free to comment, and please make sure that you subscribe for more videos.